First etch on a stone. So my drawing is completely finished here. I know that I don't want to add anything else to it. So first off, I'm going to transport that stone over to a surface that I can easily clean. So I'm going to be doing this on the press bed. So I'm going to, you can see my completed image here. I'm wearing gloves because I'm going to be handling acid and chemicals. So I'm going to remove my anything that's on the stone, transfer sheets, anything like that. And first off, I am going to apply rosin powder to this. So rosin powder is basically kind of ground up tree sap. And this is going to stick to my greasy areas to kind of secure those in place. It's kind of a an abrasive material, so you have to be careful how hard you apply it. And then I'm using a soft brush to do that. I barely need any of this powder. I just need enough to have it stick to the image. So next is the talc, similar to the plates. And I'm just using a soft bristle brush, making sure I hit every bit of the image and that things have stuck to it. So I'm gonna brush off any of this excess either into the trash or into my rosin and talc box here. And then we're gonna be doing a progressive etch on the stones. There's different methods of etching stones. I like to do a progressive etch, which means we're gonna slowly be adding acid to just one shot glass of gum. So a lot of people will mix up different concentrations of acid and different shot glasses. I like this method because it keeps it nice and simple. So I'm gonna start with 1 ounce of gum. If you were doing a giant stone, you'd probably need double this and you would just kind of figure out your appropriate amount of acid from there. So we are using nitric acid. It is extremely important that you wear gloves. You're in a well-ventilated area here, and we're pulling it out of the acid container. You can see I'm setting all the acid contaminated pieces onto another piece of limestone. This will make sure that we don't want that reacting with the metal or anything like that here. So with the progressive etch, we're gonna start with a low concentration of acid, and it's slowly gonna get stronger as we move through. So here I started with 3 drops. The stones are different than the plates, then I do a standard etch with the plates. With the stones, it's all gonna depend on what you drew with, the color of the stone, as well as humidity, weather, everything kind of changes how stones react with the acid. So in general, a gray stone can take more acid than a light stone. And light stone, you want to keep an etch pretty soft or pretty light on something that is a yellow stone, or maybe you drew with a really light material, less greasy material. So here I'm going to start with fresh gum in the border, move it in the border first, and then over the entire image. I'm doing all this in about 2 minute increments. Making sure that the gum stays nice and liquidy throughout this whole process. If it ever gets stiff, I can add a little more fresh gum. But I'm gonna be breaking up my 1 ounce shot glass into 3 different parts. So this first part had the 3 drops of acid to the ounce. So once again, apply it to the border and then over the entire image quickly. And now I'm gonna add more drops to my etch. So be careful touching things with your gummy hands. You can see I have that one hand that's been used to touch the gum, one hand that stays kind of clean with the gloves. And I'm gonna add my next concentration of acid. So I added 2 more drops to this. So now I have 5 drops of acid in here, but my concentration of gum to acid has changed. So it's getting exponentially stronger every time I do this. So I start with the border again, and then I'm gonna move the etch over the whole image. keeping it active, making sure that the concentration of acid and gum never sits in one space for too long, so you kind of keep this moving the whole time. For approximately 2 minutes again. After that is done, I am gonna once again add more drops of acid. So I'm doing just one drop here. So now I'm up to 6 drops to an ounce, but remember that that amount is actually higher because I have less gum in the container. So I stir that up, I'm activating this gum again, and then I'm gonna apply the gum to the border and then over the whole image again for another 2 minutes. So here I am doing that. Once that is done, you can see I didn't use all the gum arabic or all my etch. The rest of that etch will end up in the border gum container. My acid and all this stuff, I want to get it out of the way because I'm about to do my tight wipe and I don't want to knock any of that stuff over. So first off, I'm using a damp sponge, not wet, damp, to remove all that extra gum around the borders on top of the image. This can get a little bit messy. I don't want to take off all the gum. And then I will apply a very small amount of fresh gum to the surface, just enough to get the whole thing covered again. And then I'm going to be using the cheesecloth to tight wipe this. So remember, you want it bunched up almost like the hard surface of your palm. Start by removing the excess gum with the first piece. Second piece, like you're buffing a car, so you want to make sure that you don't leave any streaks of gum on this image. So streaks of gum will prevent our next steps when we're doing the washout of the image from chunks of the image actually coming out, and so we'll have areas that roll up darker. So that last piece that I'm using, I'm just doing a really light buff to take care of any streaks that might have been on the image. This is an example of a hot etch, so this is kind of something that I don't ever like to see if I'm etching, so I'm putting a kind of an unknown amount of acid into the little tiny concentration of gum arabic that's left, and you can see when I put that on, it's a little hard from this distance, but that the stone is instantly foaming. And that means that that etch is incredibly hot. If I was putting that on top of a light drawing or a really sensitive drawing, this would probably burn out my image and I'd just have missing chunks from my image. I can use this to my advantage later if I'm doing reductive drawing methods where I want to remove bits of ink that are maybe showing up in an image or chunks of an image with a really strong etch. So on to cleanup, I want to make sure that none of that gum is hanging around on the bottom of the stone so that I don't glue it to a surface. The gum is super tacky, so I want to get it off the press bed, off the back of the stone. And then I'm going to go through the standard steps of cleaning out all my other materials with water. So the acid in the eyedropper needs to be rinsed out, the cheesecloth needs to be rinsed out, the shot glass needs to be rinsed out, my sponge and my bowl need to be rinsed out, and then remember to really, really get the gum out of that cheesecloth. And then we're gonna do the little snap out with the cheesecloth to make sure that we get as much water out as possible and hang that over something to dry. Outside is a good option for this if it's dry and warm out. Next video will be the roll up and second etch.